Hello children, once again welcome back to the session. Now we are discussing about the types of spherical mirror. So the first type is convex, second one is concave. So here we have taken a spoon, right? So if you are observing in this side, the part which is bended outward will be getting an erect image. How the image will be? It will be erect. So on the other side, which is curved inward, so if you are observing on this side, you will be getting an inverted image. So in concave lens, the image formed is inverted, and in convex lens, the image formed is erect. Okay, children. So here, what are the types of spherical mirror we have? Concave and convex. Concave is nothing but it has a cave-like structure. So keep in mind it has a cave-like structure which is inverted or bended. Sorry, which is bended inward. This is called as concave. So which is bended outward. This is called as convex mirror. So there are two types, one is convex mirror and then concave mirror. And then try to find some more examples of concave and convex mirror. And then look at here, children. So what is this? You have a torch. I have a torch in my hand now. So here, look at here. How the glass here? It is bended outward, right? So what is the reflecting surface here? So this is what type of lens mirror is this? This is concave or convex? Yeah, it is convex. So I can't open this completely. Look at here. Able to see here? So look at here. So it is bended outwards. So this is an example of convex mirror. And have you seen under the bridges, children? While traveling under the bridges on the edge, we will be having some mirrors. Have you seen that? So how it is bulged outwards? Yeah, they are concave or convex? Yes, convex. Convex only will be getting an erect image. In concave, which is bended inwards, will be getting an inverted image. So try to find few more examples of concave and convex mirror. Okay. Next one, look at here. Before going to see the properties of the image formed by concave and convex mirror, you need to know one more thing. So that is image. I said you already we have inverted and erect. So one more two types are there. Image, they are real image and then virtual image. So what do you mean by real, children? Which is original, it is present there. So which virtual, it is only an imaginary thing, it is not there. Okay, look at here. Real image is formed by the actual intersection of light rays. So what do you mean by intersection? So two or more rays comes and combines, intersection of points. What do you mean by intersection? Joining of more things. Okay. Real image is formed by the intersection of light. So how a real image is formed? When the light rays combines together, they are able to get real image. So this we are able to see on the screen. On the screen, we will be getting a real image. Second thing is virtual image. So virtual is opposite to that of real. We are not able to see the image on the screen. I am telling you screen, not mirror, children. Okay. Real image. What is it? Real image. We are able to see on the screen. But virtual image, we are not able to see on the screen. I am telling you screen, not the mirror. Keep that in mind. Images will be getting in mirror. So we have a mirror and we have a screen on the back of the mirror. mirror and then screen. Consider an object is there in between the mirror and the screen. So first we'll be seeing the image on object on the mirror as an image. So this image we are not able to see on the screen. So this is called as what? Virtual image. If you are not able to see that, that is virtual. If you are able to see that, it is called as real image. Look at here, children. So the real image is always inverted. Real image is always inverted and virtual image is always erect. How the real image will be? It will be inverted and then virtual image will be erect. Okay, so just keep in mind, real image we can see on the screen, virtual image we are not able to see on the screen. So I discussed about mirror, types of mirror, and then spherical mirror, in that we have two types, one is concave and convex. Second topic is real and virtual image. And the next thing, look at here, image appears in front of mirror. I said you right. So this is an object. This is an object. We are able to see this image in this screen. So this object appears. So the image of this object appears in front of the mirror. Look at here, children. We have an object here. We have a mirror here. Object, mirror. So the image of the object first falls on this mirror and then reflected back. So they are projected on the screen. We have a screen here. So if you are able to see the image of this object on a screen, this is called real. And look at here, virtual image appears behind the mirror. What is that? On the back of the mirror only the virtual image appears. We are not able to see that on a screen. So don't get confused with this, children. One thing is real image we are able to see on the screen. Virtual image we are not able to see on the screen. I am going to show you a video which will give you a better understanding of this topic. Okay. So next thing is difference between real and virtual image. Whether you are noting the points, hints note is with you. Good. Real image. Look at here. Here I said you right. The light rays meets at a point. Here the light rays do not meet at a point. Image formed different side as that of the object. Object is there, but the image formed is on the different side. Here the object and image are formed the same side. Real image, the image will be inverted, here erect, cannot be obtained on the screen. Can be obtained on the screen, cannot be obtained on the screen. So first point, children, difference between real and virtual image. First point, in real image, image is formed when the light rays combines or meets at a point. Virtual image, light rays do not meet at a point. And then both the image and the object are of different side. Image is on the one side and the object is on the other side. But in virtual image, both image and object lies in the same side. Inverted, erect. Can be obtained on the screen, cannot be obtained on the screen. So I am going to show you in video now. So just listen to that. It will give you better understanding of this lesson. Hello children. So now I hope you are ready to see the video. Okay. So what is it? Reflection of light. Reflection of light. So look at here, we are able to see the reflection of this building in water. Whether you are able to see this reflection of building and some other things in water, we are able to see. So in your lower classes you'd have studied about the story of lion and the rabbit. Whether you are able to recall that the story of lion and rabbit. So what is the story? Whether you are able to recall that? So there is a lion in the forest. which used to kill all the animals in the forest. So, on the rabbit day's turn, it was the day for the rabbit. So, it was late. So, the lion got angry and asked, why are you late? So, it said, there is one more lion in this forest. It stopped me. So, the lion got anger and said, show me that lion, I'll see. So, what the clever rabbit said? So, the lion is there inside this well. So, the lion looked into it, into the well. So, it saw the reflection. So, what did it thought? It thought there is one more lion in the well. So, it jumped into the well to attack the other lion. Yes or no? So, look at here. So, whether there is one more lion in the well, children? Do you think it is true? No. So, there is no lion in the well. So, what is it? Was there actually a lion in the well? No. So, we don't have any lion in the well. It is the reflection of that lion. What is it? We call it as reflection. As I said you already, reflection occurs on smooth surface. Reflection occurs on smooth surface. Now we are going to discuss this topic of reflection of light. So look at here, when he opens, so he starts the light. He glows the light. So as I said you already, light always travels in a straight line. I said you right. So if there is an object or an obstacle in the path of light, so we have a shiny surface here which acts as an obstacle for the light. So what happens? The path of light changes. That is, the direction of light changes. So this is called as reflection of light. Look at here. The phenomenon of change in the path of light back in the same medium is called as reflection of light. So here, what is the medium here, children? Air medium. So I said you, in laws of reflection, incident light, and this is called as reflected light. Here, a girl combs her hair by seeing her face in the mirror. Look at here. So what do we observe on the mirror? We observe our image. We are able to see our image. So the one which is responsible for the image is called object. And the thing which we see on the mirror is called as image. Right? Who is responsible for that image is called as object. And the thing which we see on the mirror or the reflecting surface is called as image. So, where does we get image? Only on the reflecting surface by mirror. Now, we are going to see the reflection by plane mirror. What is it? Reflection by plane mirror. So, the reflection takes place on mirror, polished surface, water, metals, etc. Here, we are going to place a mirror at the end of a chess board. We have placed a plane mirror at the end of a chess board and we have kept a coin in front of this mirror. So we are able to get an image which is laterally inverted. We have seen already in the right, children. So this is the object, it is the image obtained. So here the right one will be observed as the left. I said right, lateral inversion, ambulance, why it is written in the opposite form. Yes or no, children? So, object and the image. So, they are inverted. So, if we move it front, the image also moves. If we change the position of object, the image also moves from one place to the other place. Okay? So, the distance between them are same. If you keep it near, it would be near. If you move it back, it would come back. So up to this, I stop, and in the next class we will continue the